The time is around 500 BC. The place, Greece. The city-states of Athens and Sparta vie for dominance over the peninsula. The Athenians head the alliance known as the Delian League, while the Spartans lead the Peloponnesian League. And, at Colonus, something was going on that would change the world for thousands of years.
Sophocles, you wealthy armor manufacturer! Our child will be a great man! I can feel it! What should we name him?
We will name him Sophocles.
Sophocles, did you hear? Themistocles leads our ships to victory at the Bay of Salamis, even against a larger Persian force. We crushed them.
Wow, that's great.
Oh, too bad. Only 16. Too young to fight.
Sophocles, I bring good news.
You have been selected to lead the chorus at the Pan to celebrate the victory at the Battle of Salamis.
Wow, that's great. I've always wanted to be in the choral chant.
Not only that, but you get to do it naked.
Naked?
Yes.
Oh, joyous day!
Stop! Put down your styluses! I will now collect your plays. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Alright, we're gonna go judge these.
Sophocles, how'd you think you did?
I don't know, but I think this one's pretty good.
Oh, by the way! Instead of the usual judges judging this one, it's being judged by 10 of Athens' most famous generals.
Oh god, what I wrote better be good.
Oh no! This little newbie scared of the big judges? Maybe you should have saved yourself the stress and drop out. Leave the competition to the establishment, to me.
Aeschylus!
Well, I'm off to go attend to my victory party. So long.
Wow, Aeschylus' plays are really famous, but he's a real prick, isn't he?
Yeah.
We have now judged the competition, and we're gonna just post the list of honorable mentions, but we're going to list first and second place publicly, so you ready to celebrate? And in second place, Aeschylus!
I knew it would win second place. At least I should have been, I don't know, maybe honorable mention. Now, first place is probably going to be one of the students again.
Wow, Aeschylus got second place? I wonder who got first.
And in first place, the newcomer, Sophocles!
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Sophocles, I was pleased to hear that you won't be going to another city to write plays for a foreigner like Aeschylus and Euripides did.
No, sir. I wouldn't leave my home city.
You're such a patriot for Athens. And your family is very wealthy, so you must know a lot about dealing with money, am I right? Because I'm quickly gaining political power in the city, I've secured for you an appointment as a financial officer in the Delian League.
That's a great honor, although I don't know why you want me.
Well, the people of Athens love you for your plays and your patriotism, and the leaders love you for your family's financial success. So it's a perfect fit.
Well, thank you, sir. I'll do my best.
Excellent. I see a great career for you, not just in playwriting, but in public service.
I'm afraid the reports that the city of Samos is rebelling against Athens is true. This just in, Athens is getting ready to mobilize an army. You heard it first on GNN. This is Anderson Christopoulos signing off.
So, I think you heard the news about the rebellion.
I was on my way here and I saw Pericles. I think he wants to talk to you about something.
That's right, Sophocles. I do need to talk to you about something. Because you see, we, the leaders of the Athenian Empire, want you to be one of the generals in our Samnian campaign to put down this rebellion.
But I don't even know about the military.
That doesn't matter. We don't actually need you to lead the troops. It's just that all of Athens is reveling in the success of your recent play, Antigone. And if the troops got to travel with somebody as famous and as popular as you, it would be a big boost to morale.
I don't know. I'll have to think about it.
Pericles, I've been working on this play for a while now, and it would be such a drag if I just suspend the production of it. However, it would be doing good to this country, so after a while of thinking, I think I'm in.
That's great. Many thanks, Sophocles.
All right, brave soldier. Let us win. Win for Athens.
For Athens! And for you, Sophocles!
Sophocles, congratulations on winning. I thought my plays were going to win, especially Alessis, but your playwriting is incredible.
Thank you, Euripides. It's good to be back home. I mean, it was exciting watching Samos, watching our victory at Samos.
I've heard rumors that Aeschylus' son is getting into playwriting. He might start becoming competition soon.
He's no match for me, but I still better go home and get to work.
All right, I should do the same.
Good day, sir.
All right, Sophocles, it's down to the final three.
And in third place is Euripides and his play, Meridia.
It's not as high as I'd like to take it.
And in second place, Sophocles with his group of plays.
Well, looks like there's a new contender in town with new plays, but fair enough.
And in first place, Euphorion!
Ha! It is I, Euphorion, son of Aeschylus. I have once again brought pride to my family and have gotten victory over all you inferior writers.
What'd you say to me?
What'd you just say to me?
Inferior writer.
Trying to act cocky?
Inferior writer, yo!
Whoa! Whoa! My play be better.
Whoa, bring it up,
Yo, whoa. You're lucky this line holding me back.
Looks like he got his father's charms.
Oops, I thought we were done.
Hold this, Aeschylus, alright?
Well, it was a good run this year. Now it's back to work. I need to think of a name for my main character of my next play. Maybe Metaphys? No, how about Jedipus? Or...
Yeah.
Sophocles, I saw your play, Oedipus Rex. It was super great. It's a pity that it will only want second place to that nephew of Aeschylus, Philocles.
Yeah, I think it was one of my best plays so far too. Anyways, have you heard anything about the Peloponnesian War with Sparta?
Oh yes, I bring some grave news. The plague caused by all these refugees coming to Athens has killed your benefactor, Pericles.
What? This is terrible news! No!
Oh no!
Anyways, it's been such a grief that I can't produce any more plays for at least a year.
Sophocles, any new plays you've been working on lately?
No, but I just finished this new hymn in honor of the god Asclepius, the healing god.
Oh yeah, word around town is that you built a small shrine in honor of Asclepius because the temple hasn't been built yet.
Yeah, I'm very inspired by this god. I really love him. Comes from my heart. Like, Asclepius, such an amazing god.
Wow, such devotion.
Many worship.
Such Greek.
Much religion.
Iophon, I can't believe you accused our father Sophocles of being insane and have now forced him to come to court to defend himself.
Come on, Ariston, the guy is over 80 years old. How could he not be insane?
He's clearly not insane. Just a short while ago, he was chosen to be one of only 10 counselors to deal with the Athenian Navy's defeat at Sicily. And they don't choose insane people for that. You're clearly just upset because he spends more time with my son than he does yours.
You're not even a legitimate son, and your grandson is not legitimate either. Just because you name him Sophocles doesn't give him the right to favor him over much than mine, alright? But no, this is a reason why I think he's insane.
Sons of Sophocles, the judges made his verdict.
Really? What happened?
Well, Sophocles first said, if I am insane, then I am not Sophocles. But if I am not insane, then I can be Sophocles.
Then what?
Well, after that, your father read the judge Sophocles' new play, Oedipus at Colonus, and the judge simply ruled that if a man can write such a good play, then he's obviously not insane.
Ha! Damn it!
See, Iphon, stop this foolish jealousy before you do something even more stupid.
Fine.
Oh, such a pain to go on this walk.
Indeed, the death of our father Sophocles will be mourned not just by us, but by the people of Athens. So, where are those Spartan fortifications supposed to be, anyway?
Oh, I think we should be able to contact them soon, I think.
It is I, the Spartan general Lysander. Who goes there on my road that I command?
I am Iophon, son of Sophocles, and this is Ariston, son of Sophocles. We have come ahead of our main party to persuade you to let us trudge this path to our burial rite in Decleia.
Yes, Decleia. That is where our family's tomb is located, and we must bury our father, Sophocles, at Decleia.
Although, here in Sparta we have heard of Sophocles' play, and we enjoy them very much, an enemy from Athens. Cannot pass through my road. I am sorry, but you cannot bury your father here.
Well, this could be a problem.
Oh, Dan, we should camp here for the night, and we should think of a solution in the morning.
All right.
So, have you found any solutions in the morning?
The sun is not completely risen. Perhaps we could sneak by the Spartans in the dark.
I'm afraid that won't be necessary, as the god Dionysus visited me in my sleep and told me that Sophocles has contributed a great amount to drama, and that you will be able to bury him at his tomb in Decleia.
Thank you, Lysander.
Yes, this is great. Now we will be able to fill our rites and bury our father in his ancestral tomb.
Hurrah!
Yeah! Walking.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction, oh, beautiful release. Memories seep from my veins, let me be empty.
Sophocles.
Philocles.
Aesculapius.
Aesculapius.
He's very good.
Ow!
Hey! Time's up. Thank you.
Works. Good enough.